4 years of planning, the new Hamburg Community Playground is closely becoming a reality. Not quite yet. They need a little bit of help from some people. Volunteers helped to design this playground. Well, now, volunteers are needed to help build it. The volunteer committee is asking for actually hundreds of skilled and unskilled builders for 4 building dates. It all begins on April 28th, rain or shine. City of Buffalo is giving away 500 trees today in honor of Earth Month. If you stop by Niagara Square today, you can score a free tree until 3 o'clock this afternoon. There are maples, birch, oak, redbud, and hackberry trees. Take your pick. They come in a 2-gallon pot, and officials say that they're easy to transport and transplant. And speaking of trees, we decided to get a head start on the Cherry Blossom Festival starting next week. As you can see, they are in full swing right now at Delaware Park here in Buffalo, but they could be at risk due to the weather conditions for tomorrow. So quick, get out and take a look. But check in once again with our meteorologist, Donna Lewandowski. She's tracking your 7 First Alert Most Accurate Forecast midweek.
And we have to get to them in between some rain showers today. This is what SkyWatch was able to pick up this morning. We had rain coming through, and then we saw just to the north, we had those rain shafts coming through, 7 portions on Ontario, Fort Erie, and then right through Grand Island as well. A little bit of dry time out there, and we're going to be dealing with a little bit more rain as we head into our afternoon. And on top of that, thunderstorm activity, the potential is there for our Thursday, especially in the afternoon and evening. Colder, much cooler behind this frontal system for Thursday or for Friday and Saturday. And then by Sunday, temperatures begin to moderate. We dip back down mid-60s, but at the end of that tunnel, we are dealing with temperatures in the 70s. So that's on the other side of the 70 that you just can't see quite yet. Temperatures right now near 60 degrees from Buffalo to Dunkirk. A little bit cooler for the southern tier with that southerly wind still in place. More of a southwesterly wind. You can kind of see it in the lines that we have pulling up from near Dunkirk and Buffalo. That will start to shift a little more southwest. And with that, we're going to get the lake shore to cool down a little bit. Also, the gusts are going to be a little bit higher for the middle of the afternoon as well. So you'll be fighting with the umbrella, unfortunately, as we make our way into the afternoon. On 7 Super Doppler, I was mentioning rounds of rain. We had some dry time here in downtown, and what we're going to see is another round coming through. Light for the first batch that we have out there now, and what we're going to deal with is we head into the later afternoon hours between that 2 and 4 o'clock time frame, some heavier rain, but this is what we're looking at for Dunkirk coming in just at around 10 to 1. Welland, that's just to the west of Niagara Falls. That's coming in just about 1:30 and then closer to 2. Now, this is for that big batch that you see coming through southern portions of Ontario. The day planner for our afternoon, again, we're going to have some areas of showers out there. Temperatures will hover near 60 degrees, and then through this overnight period, we are going to dry out. We're going to stay pretty cloudy through the overnight period, but also mild with temperatures near 50 degrees, and this is how we're going to get there. Again, rain showers coming through. Potentially some heavier downpours into the afternoon commute, especially as you head south. As we head into the evening, that heavier rain from Wellsville to Allegheny, northern Pennsylvania will be there, and then we'll have it a little bit more scattered from Buffalo southward, where we're starting to see that more so for Buffalo northward. Now it will be Buffalo for Hamburg and Springville southward for tonight. Through the overnight, we're dry. The rain picks up again during the afternoon, spotty at best for our noon hour. Between 3 and 6, this is where we're going to have these scattered storms coming into play. As we go to 7 through 8 o'clock, we're watching this line pass by. It'll be down across the southern tier later on in the evening around 11 o'clock. Temperatures, though, will be mild in the mid to upper 60s. And then again, so much cooler air on the backside of that. 50 degrees breezy. We'll have rain showers on Friday, drying out this weekend, mid 60s by Tuesday. You're watching 7 Eyewitness News at noon. We'll be right back.
A new drink to tell you about today. Unicorns may be a myth, but the unicorn frappuccino is not. Starbucks has rolled out this colorful drink today. It's a cream frappuccino with pink powder, mango syrup, and then blue drizzle. But you better get one quick. It's only available through the end of this week. Time now to check in with Howard today, see who's cooking up for us in the Mr. Food Test Kitchen.
You've probably heard the saying that everything old is new again. Well, that seems to be the trend we're seeing on menus across the country. Comfort dishes like mac and cheese, old-fashioned meatloaf, and southern shrimp and grits are finding their way onto menus at some of the most popular restaurants coast to coast. So let me show you how easy it is to whip up some shrimp and grits that are so good your taste buds will be doing a happy dance. We start by cooking some bacon until it's nice and crispy. While that finishes up, we add some grits to a pot of boiling water along with a good amount of salt. We discovered the trick to making really good grits is to be generous with the salt. Now we take our bacon out of the skillet, and in the bacon drippings, we cook some shrimp along with a bit of minced garlic until the shrimp are pink. Now that our grits have thickened up, we stir in a good amount of cheddar cheese. And to give our shrimp lots of flavor, we add a little lemon juice, a splash of hot sauce, and some scallions. And when we serve the shrimp over the cheesy grits and finish it off with some crumbled bacon, are you ever in for a treat? To get this easy recipe for our southern shrimp and grits, all you need to do is visit our website. I'm Howard in the Mr. Food Test Kitchen, where today we found a new old-fashioned way for you to say,